started. Are you guys ready for a show?
Yay!
Ooh, good crowd. I was expecting to find like 12 people waiting here. I figured after the big grand march, everybody went home. Anyway, we're going to get started. Hey, I'm going to ask you real quickly to turn your chairs around and face me because I am narcissistic and the next hour is all about me. And that includes you, pothead. Just turn around. His head looks like a pot from here. That's all I mean. Anyway, my name's Alan. It's easy to remember. It's a four-letter word. Ask either of my ex-wives. My dad called me son. I later found out that was short for something else. I am from San Francisco. To answer your next question, no. But my husband is. And we're going to do a comedy hypnosis show. How many of you have seen a hypnosis show before? Yay, hypno junkies. How many of you have never seen a hypnosis show? Yay, virgins. How many of you just refuse to raise your hand because it's a hypnosis show? More potheads. You're not alone. All right, for those of you that have never seen a hypnosis show, people want to know a couple of common questions before I get started. Question number one is usually, Alan, if I volunteer and I sit in one of your 12 chairs, are you going to make me do things I would never do in front of my friends and peers, bark like a rooster, milk a duck? Of course, those answers are...
Yeah.
I do promise you, as you leave the stage, over by this little speaker, you find all your clothes neatly folded. Except for the clothes he puts on, because he's a pervert. And I don't know what he's going to wear to work on Monday. And the smile on her face, she's glad she's with him. That's good. He's even laughing more. I don't do anything against anyone's morals or ethics. First of all, I'm not a politician. Second of all, I have very few religious affiliations other than I was born Jewish. I know that because I have a Jufro. And I also get lost for 40 years every time I get in my car. Second question people want to know is what type of weak-minded person makes a really good subject? Actually, it's just the opposite. You need a vivid imagination. You need to be able to focus, concentrate for more than 15 to 30 seconds. People that can't pay attention for more than 30 seconds oftentimes have an IQ of less than 50. This makes them legally an idiot or an imbecile. So when I ask your volunteers, if you're married to one, don't ask them to come up here. And do not look at your spouse right now. That's bad timing. Alright, really there's one person I'm going to avoid, that's anybody that wants to challenge me and they're thinking, yeah, I bet he can hypnotize me, I'm going to show him. Where are you going? Stand. We're going to talk about you. Alright, how many want him to leave? How many thought he'd never leave? There's a lot of love in this town. I think you're buying drinks for them. I forget where I was. Right. Anyway, hypnosis works on two premises. One is the power of our imagination. The other is the power of suggestion. Okay, we can control both of these things. Other animals in the animal kingdom have vivid imaginations and they're very intelligent, but they can't control these things. So for example, if I told you to think of a dolphin, you think of a dolphin. If I tell you you're riding on the back of that dolphin and there's a bridle in your hands, and there's reins in your hands, bridle in that dolphin's mouth, and you're jumping through the waves as though you're surfing, and now you're in a space shuttle, and you're looking out the window, and you see Earth, and it's more beautiful than any photograph you've ever seen, any video. And now you're in a submarine, and you're looking out the window, and there's beautiful rock formations, and coral, and funny-looking plants, and different fish of every color. You're on a tropical island, and you see palm trees and sand. Only human imaginations can jump from thought to thought to thought like that. We also worry about our retirement plan. You know, other animals don't have those things. They don't worry about these things. We also have the power of suggestion, and we can control that as well. Everybody put your hands together, like this. I realize some of you don't go to church. This will only be uncomfortable for a moment. Good. Make sure your palms are together, your thumbs are crossed. Pick up your two pointer fingers, your index fingers, your second finger. It's the one you pick your nose with. Don't show me. Take those two fingers apart and stare at your fingers. Just look at your fingers. Don't take your eyes off them. I'm going to screw your fingers together. Watch your fingers as they begin to draw themselves closer and faster, tighter, till they want to touch. You can try and hold them apart, but as soon as you relax for even a moment, they go right back together again, like magnets. And of course, you can take your hands apart by a show of your applause. How many of your fingers wanted to go together or did go together? Your knees went together. Why can't you do twice? Folks, I'm not going to pick you. You have to want to take a vacation in the mine. The people that come up here, I have only 12 chairs, it's a limited number, but the people that volunteer have the most fun. I got one simple rule, you gotta be 12 or over. If you're 12 or over and you want to be in the show, I'm gonna play some music for 2 minutes, you decide if you want to come up here, then we'll start the show. All right, it's just that simple. All right, a round of applause for our volunteers. You guys get to watch. We're going to hypnotize the audience. Sleep, child. That works. I can see you. I know you have camo on, but I can see you. Good. All right, anybody sitting next to someone you would consider your best friend? Someone you go shoplifting with? Anyone sitting next to someone they're infatuated with? Other than him, he's in love with everybody. Anybody chewing gum? We just had dinner, so probably not. If you have a cell phone, please turn it off. Actually, take it out of your pocket, turn it off. If you have a beeper or a pager, you really need to go downtown, trade it in, and upgrade. The kids don't get it. He's getting another watch. Cool. Shake hands with the people next to you. It's nice to know the people you're going to sleep with. I know, I expected him to jump up and shake everyone's hand at that point. All right, folks, for the next 10 minutes, I need you to do me a favor. You have to be as quiet as possible. If you make any loud, brusque noises, it not only distracts them, but it also distracts me. Just for the next 10 minutes after that, you can make as much noise as you want. If the person next to you starts to laugh, that's really the biggest problem for the next few minutes. After the 10-minute period, you can laugh all you want, but for the next 10 minutes, if you start laughing, they start laughing and lose their focus. So if your neighbor starts to laugh, reach over, smack them right upside the head. It won't shut them up, but it will make you feel better. Go ahead and practice. That's nice. They're bonding. You're pissing her off, though, right? She's going to hit you back and angry. Love that. So I'm going to hand each one of you a helium balloon. I want you to hold on to the string of this balloon. Just hold on to that string now nice and tight. Because as I fill this balloon up with more and more helium, it's going to get bigger. As that balloon gets bigger and bigger, it's going to begin to float higher and higher. And as it floats higher and higher, it's going to begin to lift your arm higher and higher. Just hold on to that string now nice and tight. As we begin to fill it with lots of helium. As that balloon gets bigger and bigger, floating higher and higher, it begins to pull your arm higher and higher into the air. It begins to pull you upright in your chair. That balloon's getting huge, floating way up above your head. You may need two hands to hold on to that balloon as it gets larger, bigger, fuller. That balloon's huge, just the size of a hula hoop. It's the size of a pickup truck, a big dually with a king cab. Look at the size of those tires as they get larger, bigger, fuller. It may even begin to pull you right out of your seat. We're going to cut the string now, and as we do, your arms will fall, and when they fall, you'll fall two times deeper. Sound or sleep, snip. Well, some wise guy here at the party found some glue, and he put paste all over your seat. You sat down on that chair, and now you're glued fast to that seat. You can't get up. You'd like to get up, walk around, visit your friends, get something to eat, something to drink, but right now your bottom's glued fast to that chair, and you can't get up. You can sit up, but you can't stand up. Go ahead, fight with that chair. It's a wimpy little chair, too. I mean, you can probably carry this chair above your head, around this entire complex, probably from here to the high school and back, but right now it's glued to your bum, and you can't get up, and you gotta go to the bathroom. Really bad. Man, do you need to go to the can. Oh, you can taste it. You gotta go so bad. Your clothes are getting tighter. You're getting that little cramp in your sides. You just gotta go wee. It's like that time you're on the interstate. Bottleneck traffic, both directions, not a rest area for miles and not a tree in sight. And you had to go really bad. Whee! Maybe if you yell wee, it'll help relieve the pressure. Go ahead, just yell wee! Yeah, the louder you yell, the better it feels. Whee! That's all right. You've actually got excellent control of your faculties. Everybody reach up, touch your nose. You won't have to go to the bathroom. Everybody just reach up, touch your nose. She's having trouble. And then just everybody lean to the right. Everybody lean to the right, except for you. You lean left. Wherever your head lands, that's your pillow. Just reach up and fluff it up your pillow. Make it nice and soft and cushy. Go ahead, just fluff the pillow, shake the pillow, pat the pillow. And sleep. Two times, deeper sound, or sleep at this point, folks, the more you applaud, the deeper they go, the more fun you get to have. Man, is it hot in here. Oh, it is hot, and it is humid, and it is sticky. It must be 100 degrees inside the rec center. Oh, it's just hot and humid and sticky. They're boiling big vats of water. And now it's beginning to feel like a sauna in here. You can just feel the sweat. It's like dripping down your back and under your arms and across your brow and behind your ears. It's just hot and humid and sticky. Oh, it's like 110 degrees. It feels like the locker room after everyone's been showering for 45 minutes. And you just can't get dry no matter how hard you try. And the person next to you is starting to smell something awful. Oh, the person next to you is starting to reek like an old pair of gym socks. You know that lucky pair that Jack liked to wear game after game? He'd never wash them. Yeah, they'd get stiff and crusty in his locker. He'd take them out and put them back on. Then at the end of the game, when he took off his sneakers, boom, that smell would hit you. That's what the person next to you smells like right now. And I'm not sure what they had for dinner, but they just let one rip. Ah, that was just wrong. They should go to a doctor. Oh my Lord, they're lifting their leg in the air. They've got no dignity, no upbringing. Where are they from? Mandan? Oh, silent but deadly. Tell you what, I'm gonna hand each of you some deodorant. Just take this room freshener, spray the person next to you. Go ahead, just spray them really good. Yeah, you know where the smell came from. Yeah, just take the cap off and baptize them with it. Here you go. Yeah, just. Yeah, just sit up and get them good, you know, like bear spray. Just empty the whole can on them. Now they smell better. Oh, yeah. In fact, the person next to you smells really good. What a great smell coming from the person next to you. Yeah, go ahead, lean over, take a whiff. They smell awesome. What is that scent? It's like the gentle essence of a spring bouquet of flowers. Yeah, it's like potpourri. Check this out. If you lift up their arm, it smells like banana walnut bread bacon in the oven. Go ahead. Just lift up your neighbor's arm. Take a whiff. What a great smell. Oh, can't get enough of that. That's like stealing cookies from a cookie jar. Go ahead. Take another whiff. They don't mind. Yeah, reach over, scratch your neighbor's head. Go ahead, just scratch your neighbor's head. And then you smell your fingers. Smells like doggy do. Nasty, wipe it on them. Yeah, that was gross. Tell you what, I've got a big industrial fan. We're gonna put on the fan. It's gonna drop down the temperature. It's gonna get nice and cool in here. Oh, it gets rid of the nasty smell. And oh, does that feel good, doesn't it? Oh, yeah, you're getting little goosebumps where you were sweating a minute ago. In fact, it's starting to drop quite rapidly. It's starting to get downright cold. Oh, man, it's like North Dakota winter, freaking darn northern blowing down from Canada cold that's like 25 degrees. Below zero. With the wind chill factor, it's almost 50 below. You can get hypothermia when it gets this cold this quick. You need to snuzzle up with the person next to you and get warm in a way you humanly can, because you're not dressed for this. Yeah, it's a matter of survival for you and for them. Yeah, you gotta worry about your arms, and your legs, and your toes, and your nose, and your belly button. Just wrap your entire body around the person next to you and get warm any way you humanly can, because we're talking bitter cold out of the bone. One, two, three, wide awake. And everybody look up here and sleep. Give her a round of applause for being a good sport. Personal touching and count from one to three. You're gonna open your eyes. When I snap my fingers, you'll close them and go two times deeper. Sound or sleep. One, two, three, and sleep. Two times deeper, sound or sleep. One, two, and three. Open your eyes. Can you slide over one chair for me? Yeah, just slide over here. There you go. And sleep. Two times deeper, sound or sleep. Everybody just lean to the left. There you go. Just find your pillow. Just lean to the left and find your pillow. Except for you. You lean right. Yeah, someone's got a light chopstick. Good. Personal California joke, just ignore it. Wherever your head is, that's your pillow. Reach up and fluff up that pillow, make it nice and soft and cushy. Go ahead. Just move the pillow, shake the pillow, pat the pillow. It's a giant teddy bear pillow, so you just want to wrap your arms around the giant teddy bear and snuzzle up to the teddy bear. Go ahead. Yeah, just snuzzle up to the teddy bear. Give your teddy bear a noogie, noogie the teddy bear. Noogie. Give your teddy bear a wet willy. Go ahead. Give your teddy bear a wet willy. Yeah. Hey, in a moment you're all going to sit up and you're going to be watching the funniest movie you've ever seen in your entire life. It is a comedy of epic proportion. In fact, the more you laugh, the more the people around you laugh, the more they laugh, the more you laugh, because laughter's contagious that way. Everybody sit up and check out this movie because it's good. It's a knee slapper. People have been on a roll around the aisles who have so hard in this movie. I always get a stitch in my side when I watch this next scene. Here it comes. You ready? No! That's great! Look at the monkeys! They're jumping up and down making faces at you. Hey, if you make faces at the monkeys, they make the same face right back at you. Go ahead, make faces at the monkeys. Yeah, you stick out your tongue, they stick out their tongue. Pull on your ears, they pull on their ears. Scratch yourself and watch, they'll scratch just like you do. Play with your hair, and they play with their hair. Monkeys got bored though, now they're pushing those cops into that mud puddle. There's something funny about watching cops slip in the mud. They're climbing all over each other, pulling each other back into the puddle. Look, there's that one teacher you just don't like who's yelling at the cops, get out of the puddle! Yep. Into the puddle, the monkeys pushed him too. You're laughing, you're having a good time, when suddenly the movie changes. Into a chick flick. And it's the saddest movie you've ever seen. It's the most heart-wrenching, depressing tearjerker. Just kind of grabs your heartstrings, ties them up in a little knot, makes you feel sad all over. Everybody's crying! Look, the hockey team's here. They never cry. They break sticks over each other's heads, and they've got tears dripping off their nose. In the movie. He's about 6 years old. He's hugging his dog, and he loves that dog. That dog's been his best friend his whole life. And there were weeks when that dog was his only friend because he lived so far out in the prairie, and they're going to take away his dog. His parents were on vacation. They never came home. They don't know what to do with the kid. They got to send him to a boys' home, and he can't keep the dog. They told him to say goodbye to his best friend, and he's looking at the man with those sad eyes going, no, one more day, one more hour, one more minute. The man grabs the dog by the collar and starts dragging him across the street. The boy starts screaming. The dog lunges to get back to the boy and gets hit by a car right in front of the kid. Now he's lost everything. His dog, his parents, his home. But wait, look, the dog's okay. Look, the dog's all right. Yeah, the dog's getting up. He's running back to the boy. He's jumping all over the boy, and the boy's hugging the dog, and the dog's licking the boy, and the boy's licking the dog. And wait, look, there's a limousine. It's the airport. Yeah, it's United Airlines. They found the parents. Yeah, apparently United had lost the parents in the baggage compartment for 2 weeks. We left. Apparently flown United. I don't know what it is with them. But now the whole family's back together again, and it makes you feel all warm and fuzzy, except for something's in the house. Crouched behind that pile of trash. He's waiting for prey. That woman's walking towards him. She looks like your mom. It is your mom. That's your mom. Warn her about the monster. Tell her not to go by the monster. He jumps. He grabs her. She's pounding at his chest, ripping at his hair, clawing at his face. She pulls off the mask. It's your dad in a costume. Dad, what the heck are you trying to do to mom? Now, go ahead, tell Dad what you think of him doing that to your mom. And give him a piece of your mind. Shake your finger at him. That's good choice of fingers, too. And look at Mom over there. Mom's laughing, actually. Mom's cracking up. Mom got him really good for Halloween. He was just getting her back for April Fool's. They're both laughing. And they're hugging, and they're kissing like they're in high school again. They are sucking face. Hey everybody, sit up straight. Sit up straight, put on your seatbelt. Put on your 3D glasses. We're going up. State Fair. Why not? I got this huge roller coaster. 250 feet of pure vertical fury. They say you fill up the 6G force with this thing. It's a new leader. All around the Mars. We're going down. Drenched to the bone. Going back up. Sure you laugh. How many of you want what she's on? You're 150 feet in the air. Look at the people down there. They're so tiny. Wave at them. Big wave. Hello. Yeah, that's true, but they can't see us. Spin on them. Yeah, no, don't do that. Don't do that. Oh, great. Somebody spit and got the guy that works here. He just spit back. Right in your eye. All right, dude, lucky shot. Bet you can't do that again. Fuck! Right in the other eye. Dude, you're really gross. Fuck! Right in your mouth. Oh, and he chews tobacco. Oh, menthol. Oh, great, somebody spewed on him. Now he took away all the track in front of us. Yeah, I tell you, we're going to go backwards, but look behind you. There's no track there either. We're 150 feet in the air. Wait, look, there's a sign that says tighten your seatbelt. Prepare for the vertical bungee drop. Of course, if you don't want to go, put your hands in the air. Maybe they'll let you off. Too late, free fall. Whoa! Traction. Ooh, wedgie. Oh. Free fall. Woo. Retraction. Where's the first wedgie? Oh, I think it's stuck. No, I'm serious, man. I think you need surgery. Everybody stand up. Pull it out. Everyone stand up. Pull it out. Theirs is stuck. But never mind, your 3D glasses just fell off and you realize it was just a movie. You take a deep breath in, it resets your heartbeat, your pulse rate, your blood pressure. Everyone reach up, touch your nose, lean to the side, and find your pillow. Fun. It's about 75%. No, it's actually 85% live athlete's foot fungus. You got that itchy burning sensation. It's growing right now between your toes, down the ball of your foot, down the arch, right back to your heel. You got to sit up and get those shoes off and scratch those feet because giant mushroom fungus are growing right now between your toes, down the ball of your foot, down the arch. You start scratching one foot, the other one itches. You start scratching that one, the other one itches. Just get those shoes off and scratch those feet. Oh man, is that a itch? Oh, it'll drive you crazy. You scratch one foot, the other one itches. You start scratching that one, the other one itches. It'll drive you cuckoo, cuckoo. Oh, if you had some hemp rope, just get the boots off. Yeah, get the shoes off, get the sandals off, those flip-flops, whatever they are, just get them off and scratch those feet. Gotta get the shoes off. Get them off to scratch the feet, yes. Shoes off, off, bad shoes, evil shoes, naughty, naughty shoes. Yes, scratch feet, yes, yes. Oh, must get between the toes, yeah. Oh, if you had some rope, you could just like floss between your toes. That would feel good, yeah. So, you know what, if you use your sock, that'll work. Just take off your sock, floss between your toes, nice and gently though, you don't want to hurt yourself. You just want to floss gently between the toes with the sock. Yes, 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 yes. If you don't have a sock, if you're only one of your neighbor's socks, they've got two of them. Yeah, they'll give you one. Hey, if you want even better relief, grab your neighbor's foot. Yeah, grab your neighbor's foot, hold their foot really high in the air and scratch that foot. They just grab their foot, hold it really high, scratch that foot. Because the higher you hold it, the better it feels, too. Tell you what, if you want total relief, grab your two shoes. Grab your two shoes, rub them together above your head. Just grab your two shoes, rub them together above your head. Yeah, 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 yeah. If you rub them really fast, music starts coming out of them. Oh, that sounds good too, doesn't it? It's the happy song. Everybody loves the happy song. And anybody can dance to the happy song. It's got one of those rhythms that everyone can dance to. Doesn't matter what you do, and they're giving away $100 bills if everybody gets up and dances. Yeah, anyone that gets up and dances gets a $100 bill. Just get up and show them what you got. Come to an end, and as the music begins to fade, everybody wants to find a seat. And just open your eyes, find your chair. And then you want to put your shoes back on, but don't worry about your socks right now. Just put your shoes back on. You want to put your left foot in the right shoe, your right foot in the left shoe. It's a yin-yang, positive, negative thing. Yeah, it'll make sure the itch doesn't come back. Yeah, just put the left foot in the right shoe, your right foot in the left shoe. And then you want to find your sock. Can you find your sock? Is your sock off? No socks off. Okay, that's okay. We'll just keep going. Tell you what, you've all been good sports. We're coming up here. We'd like to give each of you a $100 bill. If you'd like one, just raise your hand. All right, we ask that you take your $100 and you hide it someplace on you or a pickpocket won't steal it, okay? Because there could be pickpockets here at the party. So you just can't trust everybody. So just hide your $100 bill. When we give you the $100 bill, place it someplace where no one's going to steal it from you. Now, who didn't get one? Raise your hand. There's a number of people passing them out. We don't know who got one and who didn't, so if you didn't get one, just raise your hand. Last chance. Everybody gets one, so just raise your hand if you'd like a $100 bill. Anyone else? Last chance. If you didn't get one, raise your hand. There's a lot of people passing them out. We don't know who got one and who didn't. We know we have a couple of extras here, so if you didn't get one, raise your hand. Anyone else not get one? Hey, you know what? I was talking to the police officer back there, and he said there's a problem with shoplifting here in town. If you've ever shoplifted, raise your hand, I'll give you a $100 bill. Just hide your money someplace on you where it's going to be safe and no one's going to steal it, though. Because there could be pickpockets here. And if you still shoplift, raise your other hand, I'll give you another $100. If you've ever borrowed something and not returned it, raise your hand, I'll give you $100. Yeah, if you have no intention of returning it when you borrowed it, raise your hand, I'll give you another $100. You know, Andrew Yang believed that if he became president, he was going to make sure everybody got $1,000 a month. Keep everybody out of poverty, off the streets, or at least refrigerators full. Yeah. If you think that would have been a good policy, raise your hand, I'll give you a $100 bill. Security says there is a pickpocket out in the audience. They recognize this picture from the post office. They recommend that everybody move their money. Everyone should move their money and place it someplace where the pickpocket didn't see you. And if you've got more than 100 on you, you might want to put it in different locations. That way it's safe, you know. If they steal some of your money, they won't get all your money. And then once your money's sitting, you want to sit up and look real casual. Yeah, just sit up in your chair and look real casual, like you're hanging out on a yacht. Yeah, you're kicking back, soaking up some rays up on deck. Working on your tan. Sipping on a fruity beverage. Someone spiked it too. You're drunk for this. Yippee! You're completely a neighbor, a noober. That's it, you need noober.
Renumerated.
You know what? If you're drunk, though, they're going to steal your money. So you need to sit up and look mean. That's it. Everyone sit up and look real mean. You're one mean human being. You're gangsta. Yeah, show them how gangsta you are. You're a thug. You're bad like a bear. Show them how mean a bear is. Yeah. You're vicious like a vampire. You're nasty. You're nasty like the Easter Bunny. No, don't laugh. The Easter Bunny's nasty. You know why? He has to lay eggs. Yeah, we're gonna show them how nasty the Easter Bunny is. Everyone, assume the egg-laying position. Go ahead, just assume the egg-laying position. Alright, here we go. You ready? Push! 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 And squeal like a bunny. Now shake it out. Alright, they're still laughing at us because that was just a little egg. We're going to have to lay a medium-sized egg. Alright, that position is a little bit different. Everyone assume the medium-sized egg laying position. Are you ready? Brace yourself. Push! Push! And push! 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 And shake it out! Shake it out! Shake it out! All right, you can relax. Turns out there were no pickpockets here. You didn't have to be mean like the Easter Bunny. And that's a good thing because all your $100 bills, they just turned into ice cubes. And dude, are they cold. Oh man, they'll freeze your heebie-jeebies off. Just get them out of there. Get them out of there. Oh dude, they're cold. Uh-huh. Woo! It's like that time somebody dropped that ice cube down your britches. Oh man. Woo! Did you get them all? Can't tell the cold spots and the wet spots suddenly. All right, I think they're about back to room temperature, so go ahead and open your eyes and grab as many as you want. Go ahead and grab your $100 bills. And just put them someplace where they're going to be safe and you're not going to lose them. And then reach up, touch your nose. And sleep. Young man, I'm touching. This gentleman is from Mars. That's right, he only speaks Martian. Yeah. He's never been to Earth, doesn't know any other languages other than Martian. The young lady I'm touching, she's been on a spaceship going to and from Mars, and she's fluent in Martian, and she's also fluent in English. She's a wonderful translator. She speaks both English and Martian. That's right. Gentleman I'm touching has invented a very unique form of body sign language. That's right. By placing his body in different forms and different sculptures, he can translate to people that don't speak either English or Martian. He understands both English and Martian, and he'll be our translator for those of you that don't speak English or Martian tonight. Yeah. So we're going to go over here and ask this young lady to, you can open your eyes. Hi, what's your name?
Desiree.
I'm sorry?
Desiree.
Hi, Desiree, that's a beautiful name. I have a niece by the name of Desiree, yeah. But you mean, I understand you speak Martian, is that correct?
Yeah.
Excellent. That's beautiful. Can you do me a favor? Come on up here for a moment. You know, we brought this Martian back here. He landed, we don't know how he got here, but if you could ask him in Martian to sit up, we'd appreciate it.
I love snow.
Yeah, and ask him to come on up here next to me and stand on one side of me and you stand on the other side of me. Yeah, that was great. Thank you so much. And, sir, if you wouldn't mind, yeah, we're going to ask you to open your eyes. Yeah, come on over here. If you could stand over here. We just need you to translate for everybody anything that's going on here, because a lot of these people, they're just deaf, dumb, and blind kids. Anyway, so I'm going to stand here between you. If you could move forward just a little bit. That way we can interview the Martian. And can you ask the Martian his name, Desiree, please?
I love it, Hunter.
And he says?
Eric?
I say his name is Eric. And can you ask him how he got to Earth? We'd like to know how he got here to Earth today.
It's not an ene.
What did he say?
They flew here on a spaceship and it landed on Earth.
They just got here on a spaceship, excellent. Wonderful. Ask him if he can turn his hat around so we can actually see him, because we're very interested in seeing what Martians look like.
No.
Excellent, thank you. Can you ask what they eat on Mars? We're very interested in what they eat on Mars.
Is no. No, it's nothing. No. No.
And he says,
cheese.
Cheese! They eat cheese on Mars. Excellent. We got cheese. We can definitely give them cheese. And, speaking of cheese, can you ask them what type of animals they have on Mars? We'd be interested in, yeah, we've got deer here, we've got cows. What do they have on Mars?
That is not a similar. There is a today.
And he says?
Goats.
Goats are awesome. Goat cheese. Beautiful. So clamoring, getting this information. We've been dying to know for so long. And let's see. Can you ask him what he thinks of the girls here on Earth?
That is enough. And then it's.
And he says?
Don't know.
He doesn't know yet. That's okay. He's not going to judge that. And, but we're also curious about holidays. You know, here we have Christmas and Easter and July 4th, and we have all types of holidays here. Can you ask about the holidays on Mars?
That's a funny one, yeah? What's his name?
What did he say?
You don't know?
You don't know. It's just things she doesn't comprehend. I understand. We don't understand either. I think that's about it. I've kind of run out of questions. Unless any of you distinguished scientists have anything you'd like to ask the Martian. No, we're out of questions at this point, so if you could ask him to have a seat, that'd be wonderful.
Yes, yes.
Beautiful. And if you would have a seat. And thank you, sir. You did a wonderful job of translating for us. You can have a seat anyway you'd like to sit there. Yeah, give them a round of applause. And everybody, close your eyes and sleep. Well, guess what? I got good news and I got bad news. The good news is that your $100 bills are back to room temperature, and you get to keep all of them that you'd like, and there are no pickpockets here at your party. The bad news, however, is that the boogeyman came to the party. Remember the boogeyman? Yeah, when you were a little kid, he lived under your bed, or maybe in the closet, maybe outside your window or outside your door. It turns out that the boogeyman worked for Monsters, Inc. He was there to protect you while you were sleeping. He was there looking out after you so your parents could sleep and you could sleep and everybody was safe. But he had to come back because he heard you were having naughty thoughts. Yeah, he heard you weren't washing your hands for 20 seconds at a time. Now, of course, he has to teach you a lesson. So he took your spirit, he took your team spirit, your school spirit, your town spirit, and he put it inside of a bag of microwave popcorn. And you are beginning to pop right now. Pop! You're no longer popcorn, now you're a washing machine. Wash, 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 wash. He's a front loader. Wash, wash. Spin cycle. Wash, 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 wash. And now you're a pneumatic drill breaking up concrete on the side of the highway. And now you're a goldfish, swimming around the goldfish bowl, swimming, whee, wow, whoa, look, a castle, whee, wow, whoa, you know goldfish have a memory of about 3 seconds, look, there's a castle, whoa, whee. Up, it's feeding time. Everybody up to the top of the bowl. Everybody up to the top of the bowl. Come on up and feed. Feed, food, 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 food. Good. Yep. Oh, almost. Who wants food? Come to the top of the bowl. Get your food. And now you're an old antique decorator. And someone's typing on you. Type, 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 type. Tap, 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 bing, zip, tap, 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 bing, zip, tap, 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 bing, zip, and it tickles. Tap, 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 bing, zip, tap, tap, tap. All right. Oh, there we go. And now you're a Mexican jumping bean.
Yeehaw!
Andre, Andre, iba, iba, yeehaw! And now you're a can-can dancer. Everybody join arms. Lock elbows. Everybody lock elbows. And stand up. Take a giant step forward. And kick. And now you're a prima ballerina. Everybody dance. Dance, Lipschitz, dance. Graceful like a butterfly. Leap, Lipschitz, leap. Pirouette, spin, yes, spin. Plie, bend at the knees, and leap. Now you're a belly dancer. fly. You're not in their imagination.
Or I'm flying.
Now you walk like an Egyptian.
Or I'm flying.
Keep your eyes open. That way you're safe. No knocking on another.
Or I'm flying.
And now you're an air guitar player competing in the high school talent showdown. And now you're a teapot.
Teapot, short man's got. Here is my heart, here is my spot. When I get all steamed up, I just shout.
She was raised by her grandmother. She has no idea how to do this.
I'm a very special part, it's true.
Are they special? Let them know they're special. And and now you're a Hawaiian hula dancer. Everybody in hula. Show them the ocean waves. Show them the sunrise. And the sunset. Show them the full moon. And now you're surfing USA. Oh yeah. You are looking good. Switch feet. Oh, that is sweet. Oh dude, you just caught a curl. You're in like the ultimate tube and you are riding that wave. Those people out on the shore, they see you and they're all going crazy for you. As you ride that plank right up onto the shore, you give everybody a big hang ten sign. Yeah, you got it. And now you're a cuckoo clock. You want to be the loudest cuckoo clock. Now the loudest cuckoo clock gets to live in the biggest house. Yeah, I can't hear you. Yeah, your neighbor's louder. Is that all you got? Okay, it's confirmed. You're cuckoo. And now you're just a baby. You're just a little baby. You don't know a lot about the world. You don't know why you're not happy. You don't know if you're tired, or you're hungry, or you just want attention because you're spoiled. But you don't think you're spoiled, because all babies smell this way. You happen to smell this way at this moment, because you've got a full load in your diaper. Oh my lord, you got the mother load. Oh, but somebody changed you. They did, they changed you into a frog. And you're a bullfrog. And do you want to see how high you can jump? Not how far, just how high. Hey, and now you want to find a lily pad. Yeah, some place where you can sit and eat flies all day long. Oh, there's a big fly. Get the big fly. You won't have to go to Walmart for a week. And if you get the little fly, they're like dessert. They're real tasty. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know why there's so many flies here? Because you are a milk cow. And you're a milk cow. And find the barn, Betsy. The barn's the other way. Yeah, I'm sorry, you're not a milk cow, you're milking a cow. Yeah, you're at the county fair, they're having a cow milking contest. Yeah, you ready? Go. No, boys, not so fast. You go blind. And now you're the MGM lion posing for the camera. Show them a happy lion. Show them an angry looking lion. And you're angry because you're constipated. Apparently that doesn't seem to bother them. And now you're in the circus. Oops. You're walking across the high wire. Hundreds of feet in the air. Thousands of spectators are down below. And they're pointing at you. They're applauding and laughing because you're naked. She has no idea how to take that. Ladies, you are Lady Gaga impersonators. Freestyle. Gentlemen, you are bodybuilders. Strike a pose, gentlemen. Show the back pose you did for Muscle Magazine, man. Show the cover pose you did for Vogue, sweetheart. Let's give her a big round of applause as she finds a seat on stage. We're going to keep these gentlemen up here because they are also fashion models and they would like to strut their stuff around the stage and show you some of their fashion modeling moves. Tell you what, let's give these all four of them a big round of applause. They find seats up here on stage. Just find a seat on stage. Any seat will do. Everybody reach up, touch your nose, and sleep. Hey, in a moment I'm going to wake you up. You're not going to remember one single thing that happened up here on stage today. Not one single thing will you remember from this moment past. But everything I share with you from this moment forward, you will remember deeply implanted in your subconscious mind. The first thing I'd like to share with you is that no matter what anyone tells you after you've left the stage, you will have no desire to hit the hypnotist. I don't trust you. In a moment you're going to wake up, you'll be filled with lots of vim, lots of vigor, lots of energy. In fact, for the rest of the night, you're going to feel absolutely awesome. Until you go home and your head hits your pillow. When you go home and your head hits your pillow, that's when you'll fall deep sound asleep and you'll have one of the most restful, peaceful sleeps you've ever experienced. If for any reason you need to get up during the night, you will get up, you will address that need to the best of your ability. But when appropriate, if appropriate, you'll again be able to go back to sleep once again when your head hits the pillow. Tomorrow morning when you wake up, you're going to feel fantastic. You will have had the very best night's sleep you've ever experienced. Tomorrow morning when you wake up, you're going to have one major priority on your mind. You're going to want to call or email the North Dakota State Fair in Minot. You'll want to email them and say to them in that email, hey, that hypnotist, Alan Sands, the Sandman, he's really good. You should have him at our state fair again. He's called marketing. If you're married, raise your hand. If you're married, raise your hand. He's thinking about it. If you're living in sin, raise your hand. Okay. He's thinking about it. Who's she with? Who's she with? Cool. Married? Boyfriend, girlfriend, live together? Now. How long are you dating? A couple of months. Okay. New relationship. Cool. That's good. Gentlemen, I'm touching. After you've gone back to your seat, when I say Red Bull, you're going to stand up and start running through the audience, flapping your wings, yelling, Red Bull gives you wings! That's right. When I say Red Bull, you'll run through the audience, flapping your wings back and forth in front of the stage, yelling, Red Bull gives you wings! Gentlemen, I'm touching. Gentlemen, I'm touching. Every time I say my name, Alan Sands, you're going to jump up, slap your bottom, yell, who's your daddy? Gentlemen, I'm touching. Every time he slaps his bottom, he yells, who's your daddy? You're going to run over there, slap his bottom, yell, I'm your daddy, fool. Pretty lady, I'm touching. When I say the word passion, you're going to look at your boyfriend of a couple of months. He's going to look like every infatuation you have ever had in your entire life. Oh, Lord, the endorphins are just going to go nuts from the very top of your head down to your toes. You're going to find that boy, and you're going to plant the most passionate kiss on him he has ever experienced in his entire life. You will leave no doubt in his mind that he's all the man you need. You're all the woman he could ever handle. Anytime I say the word passion, or he says the word passion, go home and hide the pillow. She's got more energy than she's had. Till her head hits the pillow. One, slowly awakening. Two, as your subconscious mind regresses back to its conscious state. Three, filled with vim, vigor, and energy. Four, as though you've been sitting next to a waterfall on a hot day and the mist has been spraying you gently. It just kind of makes you tingle all over. As you come back to full consciousness on the count of five. One, two, three, four, and five. Well, I'm sorry. Sometimes this works, sometimes it doesn't. Every show is different. We're going to find out. I'm just always curious. How long do you think you've been up here so far?
An hour.
An hour? Okay. What do you feel like?
10 minutes.
10 minutes? What's it feel like for you, tissue head?
10 minutes.
10 minutes. And what do you say, buddy?
25.
You're going for 25. Yeah, we got anywhere from 10 minutes, 25 minutes, or an hour. It's interesting, isn't it, that they lose all concept of time. There's this time distortion that happens with hypnosis that is, I can't explain it. I've experienced it, but it's the reason why we use time tunnels and we use watches as our icons in hypnosis. It's this very unusual time distortion. You can appear a little bit over an hour, in fact, in total. Let's give them all a big round of applause. You guys can have a seat. Before you go, I just want to hand you these little cards. Because you're not going to follow what I'm about to say to the audience, but that will explain it to you, and that way you can figure it out after you come back to full consciousness. Please don't talk to them as I sit down. You guys can sneak away. So, you know, I drink a lot of Red Bull, and when I do these all-night parties, I like to... It's okay, I got it.
You know, I've tried all of the energy drinks, and Red Bull seems to be the one that I like the best. And, so I've tried Monster, I've tried these little 5-hour energy drinks, I've tried the Rock Stars, but Red Bull! Red Bull's my favorite of all of them, and Red Bull gives you energy, right? What else does it do? Wears you out, apparently. Wide awake, buddy. Wide awake. Wide awake. Give him a round of applause. So my name is Alan Sands, and you can find me on the web at alansands.com.
Where's your daddy?
I also go by the SandMan, so if you look for Hypnotist SandMan, you'd probably find me. But Alan Sands is my website, so just look for Alan Sands, and you can find it there, more alansands.com. I've got about 5 or 6 websites these days. And and then, you know, I'm pretty passionate about what I do for a living. I don't know about the rest of you, but when you're passionate about something, and you just want to share that passion with them, you just never know where you are, who you're with. When the passion hits you, it's time to share that passion. Go ahead, say the word yourself.
Passionate.
That should add at least another 3 months out of the relationship. Longer than both my marriages together, so that's good. Folks, that wraps up our show. I hope you had a good time. If you did, let your stars know by your applause. If you're in the show, look up here one last time. Just look up here one last time. Sleep. Hey, in a moment we're going to wake you up with some applause, and that applause is for you. It's going to build your self-esteem. It's going to make you feel good about yourself. Because you are the star of a comedy show, and if and when you ever see the video, anything that anybody shares with you, all those things will too build your self-esteem and make you feel good about yourself. You were the star of a comedy show, and all this applause is just for you. Wake them up with that applause. Folks, my name's Alan Sands. You guys have been sensational. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Good night, everybody.